just read this? Welcome to the Ranger Field Training Course. The course must be completed in the specified amount of time. When you're ready to start, press the button. Is that all, or?
I always did love obstacle courses.
Get ready, Ranger. Course starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go. Again, Ranger.
Come on.
Thank you.
Ask Darling, head of research. Somebody thought this video would make for great internal communications. I'm looking at you, Mr. Tomasi. So, this is where the magic happens. Anyway, I've been here for 24 years now. I've always been here. And through those years, we've made astonishing discoveries, authored studies of grave importance, and in all this work, there is one thing we know, and that's how little we truly know. Rest assured, we're committed to keep pushing the known laws and borders of reality, and to make the Bureau proud. So, welcome. Assuming you have the necessary clearance, and do follow the safety protocols. Read the manual. Otherwise, bad things will happen.
Research sector, huh? Home of the Bureau's mad scientists.
Do you always need to wear them? And what's the deal with the Hedron resonance anyway? Despite what you may have heard, HRAs are not monitoring devices. We're not tracking your movements or listening to your conversations while you're wearing them. We do that regardless whether or not you're wearing an HRA. Think of them as a life preserver. Only instead of water, the thing HRAs protect you from is classified. One day that classified not water might pour in and you'll be glad you got an HRA keeping you afloat. And if you don't have an HRA, don't worry. It'll be quick and painless. Kidding. I'm kidding. We're making more.
She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
place is vitally important. The information on the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid. The board, all linked, intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director, the process of choosing a director, tied to all objects of power in terms of who controls them. Yes. An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions. Apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement. Native species always in the distance, and yet contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astronauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fume, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
Thank you.
Burrow doing with that thing?
Someone answer, dammit! We need backup down here!
Marshall, are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
here.
Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm sending the elevator for you. We need a talk.
She got that right.
More of you? Really?
Welcome to the party, ma'am. Marshall is right down the hall. Marshall's eager to speak with you, ma'am. She's just down the hall.
There you are. I was starting to worry. Congratulations on your appointment, Director Faden. I'm Helen Marshall, head of Bureau Operations. Zachariah's dead, then. And I assume you found his gun.
Just call me Jesse. Trench told me to find you. He said you could help.
And he told you this through the hotline. Makes sense.
None of this phases her? Really?
Here's the situation. Darling created the HRAs in a lab nearby. We need more if we're gonna survive this attack. My Rangers can't secure the lab alone, not against those things. We need more firepower.
At least she seems to know what's going on here. She could know about Dylan.
I can clear out the hiss. I'll be your firepower.
That's a good answer.
Is she testing me?
Darling has systems in place to protect his labs. This should help you get past them. We'll talk more after you clear out the hiss. Rangers, let her through. We'll have to lock the door behind you. Sorry, but we can't risk a breach.
The layout of this place almost invites an ambush. Guess we never thought we'd be fighting on our own turf.
Seriously, I've been in Threshold safer than this.
Let's still turn the house into a Threshold, right?
Them.
Fire it! Altered item number 52AE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the item. First, a low voltage electric shock. No response. Next, I will introduce heat via a standard Bunsen burner. No response. Next, a series of solutions will be applied, each with a different value on the pH scale, from 0 to 14. No response to any value. Next, I will attempt to communicate. Can you understand me? Can you understand my words? Quack, if you can understand my words. No response. This concludes session 2. We'll need time to prepare further tests.
This way to the lab? Okay. You must like these HRAs. Sounds like Darling built them. And most of the things around here. If Marshall can't help us with Dylan, he's our next best bet. Assuming he's not dead. Or taken over by the Hiss. You led me here. Any idea how to make it work?
Hello again, Director. It appears we have a new problem. We need to get the HRA machine working.
I've replaced a couple of spark plugs, but this looks a bit more complicated.
Darling must have had a system. Randomness isn't in his nature. Punch cards, the symbols, the terminals. How do they connect?
I'll see what I can do.
So, we need to find all the punch cards. Each punch card should correspond to a terminal. These whiteboard drawings may be important. Looks like he was working on something to do with these symbols. Symbols mean. What do these whiteboards mean? Try different combinations. One of them has to work. Prism shattered. Darling's prototypes have a lot of issues. We need a new plan. We need more Blackrock prisms to make this machine work. Darling has another lab, down in the Blackrock processing site and maintenance. That must be where he keeps the prisms.
I've been to maintenance already. I can find my way.
But how long will that take? Nothing here is simple. I need to ask her now, before I go.
I need something from you first. What do you know about Dylan Faden?
I knew this was coming. Lives are at stake here, and we need this machine working to save those lives. Once that is done, Director Faden, then we can talk.
She's right. As much as I don't want to admit it, I'm the only one who can help.
Fine. I'll get the prisms first.
Dylan will have to wait just a little longer.
But don't call me Director. Jesse is fine.
I'll call you Faden. Here, you'll need this keycard.
Thanks. Emily Pope has set up a base in Executive. Once I have the prism, I'll meet you there.
Right. I'll move out immediately. And keep an eye out for Darling. Finding him might be the key to stopping the hiss.
It's just one large scale HRA. It's there now. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedron resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedron can provide us and keeping us from being wiped out.
Here, this will lead back to Central Research.
Marshall knows something about Dylan. Is he here? Is he all right? HRA's first. They'll help save everyone, including Dylan, once I find him. Can you keep him safe? Like you do with me?
I don't think anyone's there, honey. Come on, we'll go to that motel we passed a while back.
Thank you.
Okay, we need to find a way to Blackrock Processing. That's where Marshall said we'd find a prism.
Glad to see you're still you.
Medic, what's the damage?
They've each taken a few hits. We need to get them to a surgical station ASAP, but I don't think they're stable enough to move.
Ranger squad Charlie 7 returned from an expedition to the quarry threshold just after 0500 Zulu. Can you please state your names and describe the purpose of your expedition?
Kevin Horowitz.
Rupert Wells.
Our mission was to map quarry grid coordinates G29. Secondary objective, as always, was to find a route from the threshold entrance and maintenance to the formation.
I'm not doing so hard.
Secondary objective,
you're fine.
Not a success.
We'll push through this.
Water supply.
The hiss of the ones doing it.
And did you encounter any previously unrecorded event or entity while inside the threshold?
No, nothing. Do you think we should tell them about the mermaid?
Excuse me?
Yeah, the mermaid. Horowitz here found this mermaid in the quarry, just sitting on some black rock. She was singing this beautiful song, and he was overcome with desire. Oh, she was so alluring.
I'd say she was more enchanting than
hey,
alluring.
The deal.
Fine,
the hiss,
enchanting.
I buy a shot.
Cell phone. Did you tell your CO about this?
No. Because it didn't happen.
Nothing happened. As usual, the quarry is full of rocks. That's it. Can we go now?
Fuck you guys. Get out of here.
Hey, thanks for bringing down that... whatever the fuck that was. But we are barely holding on here, boss. How's the situation outside maintenance?
What do I tell him? The truth is harsh, but... these people seem familiar with death.
The hiss are everywhere. Most of the Bureau is lost. We need Blackrock Prism to make more HRAs for any survivors in the safe rooms. I'm here to check Darling's Blackrock lab.
So to recap, death, disaster, and imminent destruction. Another day at the FBC. But Darling's lab is just past Blackrock processing. I got good news and I got bad news on that front. Good news is, it's right down the hall. Bad news is, a hiss monster has decided to move in, so that's great.
Monster.
That's what the Rangers said. The ones that survived, anyway. But we are just treading water here, and the hiss keep coming. Salvador would know what to do, but apparently he took a security team into the containment sector just before the lockdown happened, and... well, no one's seen him since. But hey, at least we got you, our fearless leader.
They shouldn't rely on me. They don't know me. They don't know how I failed people.
You've done a good job here, Arish, but you should take your people and get to the base and executive. You can regroup there. I'll go deal with this monster. I'm getting kind of used to them.
Aye, aye, Faden. And be sure to put a bullet in that thing for me.